We've got a big stage behind me here set up, and the stage is set up for a screen. And it's people are saying, why is there a stage set up? I said, it's going to feel like a concert. So they're going to make it look like a concert. So it, right now, there's a bit, anticipation's in the air. You can feel it. It's electric around here.
Yeah, that's not humidity. That's
no, it's
that's
not
electricity.
Oh, my gosh, it's electricity. It's a, people are happy. People are buying T-shirts everywhere and wearing their finest hip shirts they can find, you know. And there's a lot of pride coming out of the city right now to see this event happen and unfold with grace and dignity, as I should say.
When you ask any Canadian, you know, think of their, your favorite Canadian band, everyone's going to say Tragically Hip. They're so ingrained in our culture. We forget that our lovely neighbors to the south also love the hip.
Yes, we do. I've been a hip fan since 1993, discovered them when I was a senior in high school, and I would have to say they have been my favorite band since.
I've had friends come up to visit me in Toronto from Nashville, and I take them to see the hip, and they're looking around, watching everyone go ballistic, and they say to me, I don't get it. What's happening here? How would you explain it to someone?
I would explain it as, if you don't know about the culture or the history of Canada, it's a great way to learn about it. Hmm. They're an amazing way to learn about it. It's how I learned about your culture and your history. Through them. So maybe if somebody's a history buff, they're kind of like history teachers.
That's amazing. Here, give me some love.
All right, you betcha.
That's awesome.
Absolutely.
Love our American friends. Talk about the hips. Ability to always be involved with charity, and you have used them a lot.
Oh wow, they inspire every one of us to do that, and it's part of why I started this, was because you see these guys around town all the time, and they're donating to, you know, pediatric centers, and they're helping us with Light of Day, and they're helping water keepers, and pretty much anything they're asked to do, they'll do whatever they can to help out. So they inspire us to then say, you know what, let's jump on board and do something and help. And in my case, it's Light of Day. But I'm sure they've done the same with many other organizations as well.
Explain what it is like to deal with them, to work with them.
Oh, they're so low maintenance. In fact, my favorite story about Light of Day with Paul Langlois, Paul was on board right away. He was our first guy. We said, we want to do this, but we need somebody, kind of a name to help us. And Paul was the first guy, said, whatever I can do. So he gets up early in the morning, and he's rock and roller, right? Early in the morning for them is like 11 o'clock. He's up at 7:30 doing interviews to help promote Light of Day. And I said, Paul, you know, I can get up and help you out. He said, no, I got this, no problem. And that's, I mean, Rob Baker, Gord, Sinclair have also been involved, and they're just as easy. They just ask them, and if they're available and they're not tied up with something else, they'll do it.
Let's speak on behalf of Miss Emily, someone that, you know, she has been produced by Gord Sinclair, has worked with Rob and Gord on the stage. What is her attitude about what makes them so special, the boys?
Again, I think it's about their closeness to this city. They're in and of Kingston. That's the Tragically Hip. They've never left this town, even though they had to go somewhere to do shows, and sometimes they lived outside of the city. But it's always been Kingston, and that's Emily too. Emily is she's from Prince Edward County, but she came here very young and started to make her way in the music industry, and was inspired by those guys.
This is a night where all of Canada is descending on Kingston, either physically or metaphorically. People connecting in to celebrate the most Canadian of bands. The sounds of the hip have been the soundtrack to my life and to so many of us in so many ways. The corners of Canada they talk about, but the experiences they describe. It's a night for celebration. It's a night to unfortunately say goodbye and at the same time. To remember who we are as Canadians.
You know what tonight's going to be all about? I said it before. It's going to be about love. It's going to be about music, of course. There's going to be passion. There's going to be compassion. There's charity involved, and of course, the big word that everyone's been hearing through this Tragically Hip tour is courage. Courage for what Gord Downie has been fighting, and what he has been courageously fighting, and he is winning. And I think that deserves a huge round of applause.
let's talk about this being Tragically Hip Day first, Mayor Paterson.
Well, this is the official Kingston City Council proclamation that proclaims August the 20th, 2016 as the Tragically Hip Day here in Kingston. And I can tell you, this is going to be a day to remember.
Do you get a sense that you are sort of hosting the party on behalf of the citizens? All of Canada's eyes on Kingston today.
You know what? It's true. I mean, I've been meeting people from all over the country and from the U.S. that have made a special trip in today to see the hip, and it's been great. I mean, everybody is just loving the atmosphere here. It's electric. There's an anticipation here. What a great way to show our support and appreciation for this hometown band.
What does it mean to you personally, a band like the Hip representing our city?
Well, you know what? I've mentioned this to a number of different people. What always gets me is what the Hip have done to give back to Kingston. That as big as they are, and as much as they have a national profile, they've never forgotten their roots right here in Kingston. I think of the fundraising concerts that they put on to raise money for all sorts of different causes. That we have the Tragically Hip Fund is one of those concerts that helps to support local musicians and artists. I mean, that to me is so inspiring as the mayor, and so that's why I have only the highest respect for these guys. I mean, you run into them around town, they're down to earth, they're real guys, and I just wish them all the best.
Happy Hip Day, sir.
Thank you.
Well, I mean, this is just an amazing opportunity for Kingston. You know, the Tragically Hip have been such a huge institution in our city and have really put Kingston on the map in so many different ways. And just to have this opportunity to come to celebrate the Tragically Hip and everything that they've done, the way they've given back to our community, is absolutely amazing.
What is it about this band?
I don't know. You know, they tell the story, the fabric of the nation, and we just came out of a very difficult election. You know, that was very polarizing for the people. And I think that this is an issue that has brought everybody together. And it's just sort of, you know, there's a spirit of goodwill and cohesiveness around it. And it's just, it's great. It's like healing for the country, really.
Mm. And they're also really giving people, I mean, going back to when I played with them in 1990, their mandate was to give to the community. So, you know, it's not a surprise that the community wants to love them back.
Do you think there's going to be tears, and how do you feel about that?
Well, I got my Kleenex right here.
We have earplugs, we have Kleenex, we've got tickets. I think there will be tears, but again, I think this is a celebration. Mm. I mean, it doesn't feel like a living wake. This feels like a for real, legit celebration of music and the guys and their contribution to Kingston and the music scene all over the world. It's a celebration.
Officially unveil the commemorative stone in honor of Kingston's own Tragically Hip and their historic 2016 concert series that captivated and united this nation. Now, without further ado, let the ceremonies commence. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your MC, Bill Welychka.
That beautiful energy hung over Springer Market Square here again, 27,000 people. We all felt those things that crowd felt at the Rogers K-Rock Center. It'll never be replicated again, that many people, that beautiful vibe that was happening here. I met people from all over Kingston, of course, all over Canada, all over the U.S. that wanted to be here. As we watched that broadcast, I knew there were people watching from all over Canada. And it is about paying respect. And I looked around and I thought, this is about us saying thank you to the guys for what they have done for Kingston, how much they have given back, and how much they have done for charity across Canada. Your music has been a friend to all of us over the years. It's there at the cottages, it's there on long road trips with our friends. I can't imagine a world without the Tragically Hip's music. So that day was about saying thank you to you. It had to have been commemorated somehow, in some way. That day is here. Woo! This moment is finally here. Mayor Bryan Paterson.
Thank you very much, Bill. Thanks, everybody, for coming out tonight. What a special way to open up this year's FedFest here in downtown Kingston. Tonight, we're going to unveil a very special commemorative stone. And from this point on, this will provide an opportunity for countless visitors and residents here in Kingston to stop at this particular spot in Market Square and reflect and remember on what was a very, very magical, very special evening here on August the 20th, 2016. I can tell you that on behalf of the city and all of City Council, this stone really is about saying thank you. It's about saying thank you to the hip, not only for what was a very special night, but thank you for all the songs, thank you for all the memories, thank you for all that you have done for this community and the countless ways that you have given back to your hometown over the years. Thank you so much.
They shot a movie once in your hometown. Everybody was in it from miles around.
Oh, everyone's just honored. It's a bit surreal, but only in a good way, you know. So we're happy about it.
Later that year, in July 2017, we caught up with Paul Langlois at the Hip's recording studio, The Bathhouse. He was there producing friend Greg Ball's new disc. The interview was just days after Gord Downie was appointed a member of the Order of Canada. His Hip bandmates would receive theirs later in the year.
Yep, very amazing, humbling, you know, excellent.
Do you understand why?
I understand why, and I try not to feel guilty about it, you know, just you know, one way you could look at it, well, you just played in a band for 30 years, that's all you did. But I'm aware that, and I know that we've done what we can, or as much as we can to give back, and I gotta think that that's a large part of this sort of honor, especially the Order of Canada. You know, it's given to a lot of people that give back, you know, some a lot more than we ever have. But so we'll take it, very honored. And I haven't talked to the other guys about it, but I'm assuming that they feel the same way I do. It's like, wow, you know, I mean, thanks very much. It's really, didn't see that coming.
In late 2017, the Hip's Rob Baker and Gord Sinclair joined Kingston's Miss Emily Fennell on stage in Kingston. This interview with Rob and Gord prior to Showtime occurred following the release of the doc, Long Time Running, and days after the passing of Gord Downie.
Em and I were talking, it was just about a week before Long Time Running came out, and I said, I have a feeling I'm just going to want to hug the guys after seeing the doc.
It is true, though. There's just that feeling of, oh, I just want to hold you guys so tight and let you know that you are loved.
Bring it in, Bill.
Why that reaction, do you think?
And I'm sure there's a lot of people that feel that way, too.
Hey, I think we all loved Gord. He belonged to all of us at a certain point. And, you know, the country kind of embraced him. He absorbed the country, and then the country absorbed him in a weird sort of way. And now he's gone back to his family, and they've reclaimed him, so.
Oh, right. Okay. Oh, I love you guys so much.